of what gamers actually want. The Insomniac Games, Spider-Man 2. Yes! And excuse me if I'm talking too much throughout this showcase. I just got a lot going on in my mind, and I gotta get it out as they show new games, man. It's just. What's going on, YouTube? Your boy is back and with another slightly different, but still great video. Excuse me, guys. I just now woke up. I understand I might be kind of late to the PlayStation showcase. This is going to be, like I said, a little bit different from regular videos, but I always wanted to try this out, you know, turning my channel into a gaming channel per se, quote unquote. But yeah, I'm just going to record my reaction to it, man. This has been a long, I think this showcase right here is going to represent the rest of the year for gaming and into the next year as well and years to come, because for the main fact that the gaming industry has been dry, man. We need good quality games. Like I said, I'm still trying to get it together, man. I should have got some coffee, but I just woke up. So let's just get into it, and let's see what they have for so far. Let's just see. Good thing about coming late is that you get to skip ahead and just get straight to the video. Let's get straight to it. Yeah, let's do that. I think I'm gonna keep it like this, right? Oh, that's better. That's better. Hold on, let me check my thingy right quick. Oops. Made this a little bit smaller. I'll put it right there. Okay, we got some stuff going on. Okay, so I think we pretty much straight. Let's just check it out. Like I said, I know I'm late. I'm like an hour or so, some minutes late. I don't care. Like an hour and 30 minutes, I think. And from the rumors, what I heard was, I heard this presentation or the showcase is going to be like 40 minutes long, but it seems like the stream was like an hour long, but we can cut it like 15 to 14 minutes because it was just nothing but, you know, the PlayStation blue screen or whatever. But like I said, the good thing about coming late is that you get to skip ahead and all that bull crap. You just get straight to the video. Okay, you got some rings on. You got kings at play. Kings and queens. Okay. She got the X and square boots on. So that's kind of cool, I guess. Boys out there playing chess. It's not checkers, it's chess. Look at my boy, look like he about to kingmate. A checkmate. Is it checkmate, kingmate? I don't care. I'm excited, man. But coming into this, I'm gonna be honest, I'm gonna keep my expectations low, because as you know, last E3 was kind of lackluster to say the least, and that's saying politely. But that's another here or there, man. This is about PlayStation and the future of PlayStation. Now, the only thing that comes that's alarming to me is that you still can't get your hands on the PS5. That's a thing, you know what I'm saying? And honestly, I'm not in a rush to get a PS5, but depending upon how this turns out, I don't know. I might want to consider trying to get a PS5, but I don't know. Let's see. Play has no limits. Cool. Like I said, I always wanted to do something like this on my channel, man. Okay, we got some Ratchet and Clank Horizon Zero Dawn. I do fully
expect... Jim Ryan, President and CEO of Sony Interactive Entertainment.
Jim Ryan.
Welcome to the PlayStation Showcase. At PlayStation, we believe in pushing boundaries and setting the benchmark for creativity and excellence in entertainment. We always love the opportunity to speak directly with our community. The new technology in PS5 enables development teams to build more exciting, immersive, and compelling worlds, showcasing their creative vision as storytellers. We've never been more grateful for the PlayStation community.
Tsushima,
so thank you for allowing us time to share some significant updates and brand new content. So without further ado, let's look at some new and amazing games.
Let's go. Show them. I'm getting tired. I don't care about nothing but nobody, Sony or Microsoft acquiring new studios. I don't care. Let's show us the games. Show us the work behind the acquisition of new studios. Not actual game.
That is what the Sith believe.
Lucasfilm art. So this is a Star Wars game, man.
Power. Now they wield it.
Okay.
We face the greatest Sith in generations.
Oh.
They must be stopped.
Oh, the Old Republic Realm remake. Okay. This is a rumor I heard about. That's been rumored going around for a long time, but I guess it's not really officially confirmed now. Alleged remake for PS5. Okay. We can't get it on Steam. I'm stop playing. This is the PlayStation Showcase. But it might be like a limited time exclusive, so I don't know. Because they do there as well. Okay, so Knights of the Old Republic remake. A lot of people. That's gonna be it. I heard that's a pretty good game. Final Fantasy. This seems like a Final Fantasy type game. Okay, we got Cheeks. Cheeks is confirmed. Oh my gosh, just the angles. The angles, baby, the angles. Shift up, Sacred View Studio. Okay, that's new. So this is not a Final Fantasy game. It look like it though. Ooh, she got. Dang. Okay. I'm definitely getting like Final Fantasy vibes, but this is not Square Enix, so. What the crap is that? This jump was good, though. Saving humankind. Oh, mankind. Sending the hope to our lives. Watch over us. Lead us into natural protection. Oh, she's praying. It's a prayer. To whom? Oh, wow. Okay, this is adventure slasher platformer, you know, type game. It looks good. Okay, some near automata vibes. That's not bad. You know, even though I never played a near game before, but it's, I heard the near automata series is pretty good. Okay, so this is different. Excuse me. What the crap? The gore, though, that's what stands out to me about this game. And the visuals. And those cheeks. But now, for this looks interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, some QTEs. Ain't nothing wrong with that, unless it's paced right, you know, and it makes sense. Whoa. Yo. Project Eve. This is nice. Why are you here? Wolfram? Oh, Death Stranding? Man, stop, man. Okay. So Project E, that's something to look forward to, I guess. But it's interesting. What stands out to me the most is the gore and the visuals, man. So that's definitely something to look forward to. Let me see. Let me guess. Dragon Quest. Oh no! This is the Tiny Tina DLC or the Tiny Tina standalone game, right? Off of Borderlands 4.
Your party of heroes can't stop me.
Or was it Borderlands 3?
Spoiler? It's you, baby.
Oh man, and you know what, I call myself as a Borderlands fan, because I'm a fan of the franchise, I'm a fan of the series. I have not played the latest installment. I think it was Borderlands 3 or Borderlands 4, I could be wrong. Like I said, it's been a while since I played a Borderlands game. And of course my favorite Borderlands is Borderlands 2, of course. The first Borderlands was pretty dope too as well, don't get it twisted. But the second one, man, I put so many hours into the game. But this, this is the DLC,
you know,
that
was. Some of you may be asking, Tina, where are there guns talked about in the fantasy world? And I am just so glad you asked, because shut up your face and get shooting!
Tiny Tina. Yeah, I remember that chest monster thing from Borderlands 2. Is that J-pop in the back? I hope I don't get copyright strike for this. Most likely, I probably will. Oh man, the loot, the colors. Oh, the pooped horse, butt stallion. That's what they call it, butt stallion.
I'm in.
You ready, newbie?
Time for character sheets, baby.
And Tina. I thought she would be older though.
Super duper hero movie.
That was a nod to Marvel. Okay, that was pretty cool though. I gotta pay the last installment though. I got to. Man, I don't know why I didn't. Anyways, keep it going. So okay, that was pretty dope. Square Enix.
I'll let you in on a secret, but I'm a pretty big deal.
Ooh.
Real big deal. We are getting out of the city, Homer. I promise we'll go somewhere that loves cats. No more fights. Clean air. Bright skies.
Spray.
Is that the chick from the Marvel game? Marvel Avengers game? The chick with the, she can stretch out. I don't know, this might be like a DLC for Marvel. I don't know, but the Marvel game.
Wait, stop.
That's what it looks like to me. Then again, I could be wrong. Again, the visuals. But then again, I expect nothing but the best because the PS5 is like,
Asuka.
Who's there?
Powerful.
And technically not Earth. Well, not what you would call Earth, anyway.
I swear to God, asshole, show yourself.
Show myself? I've shown.
Where are you?
Right here, at the end of your arm.
Hello. Oh. Yes.
Okay, so let me get this straight. I'm somewhere that's not what I would call Earth. I'm seeing freaking dragons, and oh yeah, I'm talking to a cop. Did I just do that?
We did.
I just moved it with my freaking mind. Yeah, okay, that is something I do now. I do magic, kill jacked up beasts.
Square Enix.
Now you're just being ridiculous.
Oh, that's too far. Good to know there was a line.
For one, I'm surprised there's no like Final Fantasy things going on. But this looks cool.
You are the only hope we have. You're special. You're the one that's planning on facing off with Syla. Tanta Syla is the strongest and most formidable of all the Tantas. You will be doing our land a great service by killing her.
First off, what this reminds me of or puts me in the mind of is something like of like a Sucker Punch studio would make. And that's not bad, the Forsaken. Forspoken, my bad. Ooh. Forspoken. I got my eye on that.
No name for a demon.
I am the one you seek. The one and only Tanta Syla.
Tanta Syla. Oh my god, the visuals. Get bodied. Spring 20, okay, so that's next year. Well, 2 years from now. No, next year, I'm tripping. It's next year.
For decades.
Okay, so I'm looking.
Rainbow has been the shield.
Forspoken.
The worst global threats imaginable.
Like I say, it puts me in the vibe of
biological weapons. The threat of nuclear.
Like a Sucker Punch game. Like Infamous.
We face the power of terror.
But what is this?
Our world has ever known.
Oh, Rainbow Six Siege are extraction. I don't know, man. They show gameplay of this. I didn't really know how to feel. My boy Twitch, or my girl Twitch. Hibana. Don't know who that is. Might be posting somebody. ICQ or IQC, whatever her name is.
Sledge.
Takan, Tachan.
We will think as one.
Castle, whatever I'm assuming that's him. I don't know. It might.
As one.
So they got all the guys here, it seems like. And you know what?
We enter the unknown.
You gotta give credit to Ubisoft with this one.
For our future.
Because this started off as a rumor, or like, if you remember playing like the story mode, quote unquote, for Rainbow Six Siege. This is back in the day when I was an Xbox One heavy. I used to play that game day in, day out. But back in the day, if you played the story mode, it was like a unlock mode you can play. And they kind of hinted towards like some kind of zombie type game mode. And you gotta give credit to the creators of Doom, and they took that and ran with it, man. And they finally trying to make something out of it. So, like I said, the gameplay, it looked kind of choppy because you can't play that game without having in mind like of playing like an actual Siege game. But I don't know. We'll see how that turns out for them. So, Remedy Games. It's some people that make Control. And Control was weird. Whatever, that was a weird game.
Don't go out in the dark. Stay in the light.
Island Wake.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive.
I never played the Island Wake game.
On the ferry, famous artist, no less.
Wanted to, but I never did.
Alice? Alice? My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
Last night, I woke up to a nightmare. I was missing a week. What had happened to me? I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it.
Alan Wake.
With it, I could save myself. I could save Alice.
Carl Stucky. Pleased to meet you.
Oh, Alex. Oh, what's that game called? I forgot what it was called, but Darkness something, or...
My name is Alan Wake.
Okay, Alan, I was right. I'm a writer. Duh. Yeah, Alan Wake. Yeah, I didn't play the first one when it first came on PS3, but it looked cool. It was like some kind of rendition off of, like a spinoff off of like Silent Hill or whatever. But Grand Theft Auto 5 for PS4, 5.
Hello, Franklin.
What's up?
You know what, bro? Rockstar is no rush in trying to make a new installment. I mean, why would they? They can keep milking this game. This is going to be, what, the fourth or third generation that this game been on? It's crazy. I mean, like,
it's lonely up here.
This is nothing new. This is nothing new.
Oh, man, speed up.
You can do the same thing on PC, but with better mods.
I think we're gonna literally.
You can make the game actually look crazy, more better with mods on PC. So this scene is on PS5, just is nothing. It's nothing new. Online mode is crap. Hey, that drink is butt cheeks now. That's pretty much it in a nutshell. Flying cars. I don't know if people used to use Hydras, but I think they still do. Yeah, that's GTA. We ain't worried about that. Crap. Slender Man? Let me stop. Oh crap. You can't body like that?
Critical work. People always decry the truth. When forced to face it.
I don't know how to necessarily feel about it. Still, but I think it has potential. Fear.
I will be her salvation.
Mari.
The time is nigh. The world rests on the precipice of transformation.
What's that game called that was shown in E3? What's the name of that game, man?
A new age. Well, that was kind of freaky. Dawn.
Ghostwire. Okay, that was the game. That was the game. That was the game. It was another game too, but so okay. Doesn't look too bad. Definitely caught my interest, but I'm not really too hyped about it. It does look good though. You know, but I don't know. I'm not really too hyped about it. Marvel, Spider-Man 2? Edio's Montreal?
Guardians.
Go Guardians of the Galaxy. Right.
You can't
hear. Now they did show gameplay of this. Now this kind of looked wonky. I ain't gonna lie. I think this game needs a little bit more time.
Wishes,
but it does have potential. It does have potential.
United in the light of belief, all suffering, all grief will end.
Oh. Yeah. Right.
What's wrong with you?
Oh, I think. Yeah, I think I'm having a heart attack.
Cease this at once. Fine.
Cosmo! How you doing, buddy?
I want the vibe, though.
Fire Anchor, leader of the Church of Truths.
During that ritual with the priest, they kept talking about a promise.
Like I said, it definitely has potential, man. I just think it needs more time.
Or join the cult.
So let's play with their fighting mechanics.
Always engage, Peter Quill.
It definitely could use a little bit more time in the oven, you know?
Hey, world mind. Long time no see.
The current probability of defeating
the Universal Church of Truth is
0.3%.
What?
Is that bad? It sounds bad.
It is.
I hope you've got one hell of a speech plan, Peter.
That makes two of us.
Star Fox?
Follow me!
Who's that? Okay, that looked kind of better. Okay.
By rejecting the promise, you have proven yourselves unworthy, and you must be destroyed.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
That was completely intentional. The Milano's on her way.
Right.
Thanks.
Thank you. Pre-order now, October 26th this year. Okay, like I said, that's potential, man. Don't rush it though, because I think that game could have a lot of potential to be a great game. Like I said, I love the vibe, I love the one-liners and stuff. Definitely caught my interest when I first seen it, but like I said, at the same time, the first gameplay they showed did look kind of wonky. This must be that new vampire game, battle royale game. It's supposed to be like a spinoff off of The Masquerade. I don't know if you played that game. It's an old RPG, vampire S game. It's really old. I do have a thing for vampires. I'm fully expecting, because I think we need more games like that, but like another Blood Rain. Can we reboot Blood Rain? Blood Rain was freaking cool, bro. You know what I'm saying? And at the time, it was so awesome, bro. But yeah, can we get a Blade game, Marvel game? Blood Hunt, that's what it's called. Vampire Masquerade, yeah. Speaking of Vampire Masquerade, were we supposed to get Vampire Masquerade 2? But that's neither here or there, because that game just kind of vanished, right? But whatever. But we do need more vampire games, though.
That's a fact.
Oh, this Devloop. Now, this game actually looks good. Matter of fact, I was just watching the final preview of this game last night on YouTube.
Shut up.
And the game does look interesting.
The visionaries, eight geniuses who painted up a prison and named it free.
And I heard from the reviewers, they say that the game kind of reminds you of Dishonored and mixed with
that you can never leave.
Some other game, but when I heard Dishonored, I was like, okay, good. This is a pretty cool concept.
A bunch of space.
To me, it's like Dishonored mixed with The Happy Few.
Whatever these guys are doing, all spewing eons bullshit.
It has that 70s esque vibe to it. Like Austin Powers with the colors and stuff.
This Party Island hangover is none my thing. My thing is answers. Who are
y'all seen that ability?
What do they want with me?
And why it's called Chain or something.
One step ahead. Come on, Colt. You gotta put this.
And I also heard this game is online too. Either you can turn it off or you can play online with other players. And basically, I can go head to head or whatever as you play throughout the story mode.
And some jackass wrecked
that's a pretty cool concept, but me personally, I'm going to go ahead and turn that off because
some type of experiment.
Multiplayer, I'm not really worried about too much.
Anybody remember?
Why is everyone wearing a mask?
Right. What the hell is my notes anymore?
Who am I?
Colt, I want you to remember. I want you to remember why you came here.
Huh. Is that? Damn, I look good.
Colt Vaughn.
I've imagined myself a way out.
I heard the guns is really satisfying to use in the game too. And they look pretty satisfying as well. Like they sound good. Look like the controls wonderful. Yeah, and the game does have a fully 24-hour cycle.
Gonna break this time loop?
Day and night system and evening system as well. September 14th, so that's right around the corner. That's next Tuesday, I think. So definitely looking forward to that game as well. What is this? Blair Witch DLC. Outlast 3. Anytime I see a camera, you know the camera vibes, I just automatically think like Blair Witch or Outlast, but this looks like another Control game. Or maybe Control might be going over to PS5, maybe. This is giving me Control vibes. But then again, I could be wrong. Kid Amnesia presented by Radiohead comes. Okay. Kid Amnesia? I guess. They really didn't show us nothing. But okay. Got that to look forward to. So moving right along. We are, 43 minutes in to this showcase? So far, so decent. Excuse me.
Go, go, see the neighborhood.
Wow, this is actually not my cup of tea type game I would play, but I would want to try to play this game because it gives me some good vibes, man. Like the colors are vibrant, very vivid, good looking game. And then the Hawaiian music playing. Good vibes, man.
Jump. Kaloy chumna Philip. Mia Buru.
Mia G?
Mia who?
The baboon and Nawak. It is Yakazo Ikuhu near me.
Yes, you were inside.
And she knows that in a bed.
She. Uriti.
Okay, I can see this game doing good. A game inspired by a new. Whatever that was. Oh, you actually pet that. Wow. Aw. That's a cute game. That's cute. Good vibes, too. Keep an eye on that game as well, because that game has a lot. It seems like it has a lot of potential, too. So.
The biggest pirate treasure of all time is within our grasp.
So this is coming to PS5 as well?
The task of
and the DLC or the standalone
that's
game?
That's not an easy fight.
Oh, what was it called? Lost or something? Not Lost, but something. Oh, NPC!
Last night
nice!
We saw a bunch of thieves digging around where we shouldn't.
Nice!
Oh, crap!
This is gonna look fantastic on PC. It looked pretty freaking phenomenal on PS4 Pro. But plus I need to upgrade my rig too, so that's gonna be coming soon. But this is gonna look phenomenal on PCs, man. And it's gonna play good too. But okay, so. That was some pretty good news, you know.
I'm Herman Hulst, head of PlayStation Studios. PlayStation Studios, at its heart, is a diverse and passionate group of storytellers. And a collective of AAA studios all across the globe. Everything we do is driven and inspired by storytelling. As creators, PlayStation 5 gives us the opportunity to push the boundaries of storytelling even further.
Okay.
Our world-class development teams at PlayStation Studios have already delivered such incredible gaming experiences.
So now God of War 2?
And we're only just getting started. As you'll see today with the lineup of exclusive games coming for PlayStation Studios, we're going to continue to drive innovation, advance gaming, while always embracing the legacy of PlayStation and creating games that matter. Games that you're not going to find anywhere else. Enjoy.
good. We need more competition in the gaming industry right now, bro. Because then Microsoft is completely out of the loop. This means hold up, pause it. Let's just take this in, bro. Let's just go over what we just seen just now, bro. Can we rewind that? I can't talk right now. Oh my freaking gosh. Insomniac Games. Oh my gosh. If they can pull this off, they are the new Sucker Punch Games. They will, bro. Oh my gosh. See all the dead bodies. Why are you getting up trying to fight these men? Oh my gosh. Oh, boy, we got a Wolverine game coming from Insomniac Games. Bro, I have my full trust in Insomniac Games, especially coming off of Spider-Man and Spider-Man Miles Morales. I didn't, like I said, haven't had a chance to play that game fully, but I heard it was a little step up, like a Spider-Man, not as a 2.0 or 5.0 or 1.5 or whatever. But still, they did phenomenal with Spider-Man. We all can attest to that. You know what I'm saying? What they showed at the E3 or back in, 2016, was it? When they first showcased Spider-Man on, at the showcase. We pretty much got what we've seen from Insomniac Games. It was nothing. Of course, you had haters coming out saying that. I think it was a altercation going on, or people was getting mad because some about water puddles not being in Spider-Man. Something stupid, right? Besides, stupid, right? But from what we've seen when he first showed Spider-Man, and when Spider-Man first, and actually when it released, we got what we've seen. And the gameplay, great. You know what I'm saying? So I have my full, I trust in Insomniac Games fully, man. Wolverine, bro. Look at the claws, bro. Look at the claws. I hope it's going to be like really gritty, rough, rugged. Wolverine, Logan, what I'm saying? Like, hey, we'll put the icing on the freaking cake with this, bro. What if they got Jack Human to voice this Wolverine, bro? Like, bro, freaking awesome, dog. That would put the icing on the cake. I would get this game day one, bro. And this is all they had to show. This is all they had to show. Insomniac Games, man. Let's get it, bro. What was the last Wolverine game we had? What was it? Wolverine Origins? Xbox 360, PS3? Which wasn't bad at all. The movie, okay, people crapped on the movie. But I think that was our last, like, Jack Human rendition of Wolverine in that movie. Or was it Future Past or whatever? I don't know. I forget. And then we had Logan as well. Logan, the movie Logan was pretty freaking awesome. But if he can come back and reprise his role in this game, sold. Release date. Oh, that's all we need, and I got my money spent on it, bro. I would gladly get a PS5. I swear to God. I promise you, I would gladly get a PS5, bro. I don't know what I gotta do to get it, but I would get it. This is what we need, Gran Turismo. Okay, that was pretty nice, I guess. Anyway, this is racing games. So yeah. This is what we needed in the gamosphere. This is what we needed, bro. Like, we need competition. We need actual, we need games with substance, man. You know, it's, we've been dry for so long, bro. For so freaking long. And that piss poor behind showcase or whatever they had with E3 last year. Or was it just, what was that? Come on, it's like they're not even trying no more. And I was hoping this, and what it looks like, Sony is like really picking things up again, bro. Honestly. I'm glad they had their own showcase. I'm so happy because, like, being part of that bullcrap that was called E3? No. Gladly pass. I'm glad they did. You know what I'm saying? And, but man, that Wolverine, dog. Definitely keeping my eye on that game. Definitely. Please take your time with it. Take your time with it. No rush. I'm hyped. I'm pretty sure I'm not the only person. But take your time with the game, bro. Take your time. You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm asking for at this point. If the game takes 4 to 5 years to make, so be it. If we get nothing but masterpieces, arts of work, interactive arts of work, I'm gonna be fine. I don't care. Cause CD Projekt Red, they failed us. You know, even though I still have fun with the game, and that should be enough said about it, but still, they did market the game, and their whole marketing campaign was just them basically telling us that they was going to save us, bro. They was supposed to be our savers, but of course, I got let down again because, you know, getting too hyped. You know what I'm saying? But that's beside the point, man. This, like I said, this is Sony. So, what is this?
For as long as I can remember, I have looked for an equal. Ooh. One who could push me.
Spider-Man 2!
One who could surprise me.
Look at his suit! Miles Morales!
One who could even beat me. Yet all I found is disappointment. Will one of you finally give me what I desire?
Doc Ock? No? It can't be. Green Goblin? Yes. Gotta be Green Goblin. Venom! Oh! Oh! Venom! It's Spider-Man 2! 2023! No Michael Jordan. Bro, what the? What? Okay, it's time to get games. Okay. Check this out. They delayed a lot on us. They delayed a lot. Check this out. Hear me out. Okay, we have Spider-Man. That came and went. Great game. Game of the year, I think. Was it not? Or was it? I know it's PlayStation greatest hits. I know it had to be. I think it won Game of the Year. I think it did. We have a Wolverine standalone game. We haven't had a Wolverine game in years. It's Somniac Games. Hear me out, bro. I freaking love y'all. Okay, Spider-Man 2. Introducing Venom. Can we get a Venom standalone game? Venom is freaking awesome, bro. And then it would be a perfect time following the movies. You know what I'm saying? Because, I mean, for what it was worth, I mean, it was like mixed reviews, but I love the movies. You know what I'm saying? I haven't seen the second one, but I will. But can we get like a Venom standalone game, bro? Or can we play as Venom in Spider-Man 2? Can we get like a head towards that route. Oh my God, come on, please make this happen. We need this. We need this, okay? You on the right path, Insomniac. I have my full trust in you. Don't let me down, please. Yes. Freaking, let's go back and watch that, bro. Let's go back and watch that.
One who could push me.
That's three whole characters we could potentially play as in one game, bro.
One who could surprise me. One who could even beat me.
I forgot, because in Spider-Man, we took out the Sinister Six, right?
Did
we
not?
I believe we did.
Disappointment.
And then this one, the next big baddie is a freaking Venom, bro.
Finally give me what I desire.
Oh, what if the symbiote or the alien, I'm gonna call him symbiote. I don't really like calling it alien. I mean, it is an alien, but whatever. So what if the symbiote can jump between Peter Parker and Miles Morales and you can play? Oh my God. Okay, that would be crazy. And then this suit, like Morales already had the red suit. Just imagine how that would look, bro. And the suits, that's another thing I forgot to mention that Spider-Man had. It had suits, bro. It had the suits. Just imagine what they can do with this one. Excuse me. Oh my gosh, bro. That would be crazy. Just imagine Miles Morales' suit is, like I said, it's already black and has the red, but a hint of white in there. Like white, black, but black, red, and white. Oh my freaking gosh. And then Peter Parker's suit. This is the perfect storm. This is right when Far From Home movie about to come out. It's the perfect storm, but of course this is gonna come out 2 years later. I mean, of course. Cool. But still, Marvel, bro. DC Universe can never ever. Oh my gosh! Look at this symbol! I feel like the legs should have been longer. Like, let's go back. I know I'm spending too much time on this, but bro, y'all gotta realize this is crazy. But I always felt like it was going to come, though. Right? It had to. Oh, look at the eyes too. Is this a direct from the movie? The eyes and stuff, come on, bro. Now, honestly, I felt like the legs right here should have been a whole lot longer. Or, as the video progressed, maybe show a slow pan and show different angles. The legs get longer. You know what I'm saying? That would be freaking dope. Would it not? You know what I'm saying? Like the legs should be like the two legs long right here. Two legs down here long. Freaking awesome, dog. Let's move on. Spend so much time. I'm so hyped, bro. I'm so ready. My body is ready for this game. Oh my gosh. Speaking of Spider-Man games, can we get like a Spider-Man Ultimate remake? Spider-Man Ultimate was pretty cool. Or maybe a Spider-Man Friend of Foe. Now remember the game? That was awesome. Like, freak, what's that game called? I can't remember, but can we not? Oh, bring back, X-Men Legends. God of War freaking 2, look at my mans! Of course, it's called God of War Ragnarok, but it's God of War 2. God dog it. Boy! Atreus! How long in the future does this take? Oh, he sounds older.
Does he say Fimbulwinter leads to Ragnarok?
My boy got some bass in him, boy. He ain't a little boy no more. He's growing. You know what I'm saying? I think he's like, what? I would say, what? 11, 12 years older than this one, maybe? Because it doesn't seem like it takes that far off into the future from what we left off. And again, y'all forgive me, bro. I know I call myself a gamer, ultimate gamer, or whatever. But yo, I have yet to finish the God of War game. I'm sorry. I think I'm still on the part when, you know, the maze part. When you, I do have the armor, the undying armor. What was it called? The fog. I forgot what it's called, but it's like, you know what I'm talking about. I might put it on the screen so if I can find it. But I have yet to finish the game. I'm sorry, though. I know. I will, though. I might put it on the channel. I don't know. I heard it added a lot since the last time I played this game, because I played it day one, bro. I got the freaking the collector's edition. I had to get a day one. I had to. This game was awesome. Still is. It's a masterpiece. And again, I think this game was in the making for what, 6 years? You know what I'm saying? And they came out with this. Bro, take your time. Yo, game developers. Big time AAA game developers. All we are asking as gamers, bro, at the end of the day, I don't give a freak about people being impatient about a game. I don't give a freak. Look here. And the people, the big head people that owns these companies, you know what I'm saying, the shareholders, y'all give these people time to make masterpieces, man. Whatever happened to that? We can wait. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing wrong with that. As long as you show us what you need to show, and maintain that, if not make it better, when the game actually comes out, let the game speak for themselves. Let your work speak for itself, okay? Stop worrying about the freaking money, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, that's not the end-all, be-all, you know what I'm saying? Of course, people need to get paid. People got families. I understand that. But please, man, take your freaking time with these games, bro. Honestly. For real. Because games like Cyberpunk, it still has a bad taste in my mouth. Mind you, again, I still had a great time with the game. But even now playing it on PC, bro, even I felt, I still feel like the game was meant to be played on PC, man, to be honest. But anyway, it's still problems there. You know what I'm saying? It's still problems, and it's clear as day. But at the end of the day, what I'm trying to say is just take your time, bro. Please put out good quality shit. Excuse my language. That's all I'm saying. We need this, man. We need to bring the game industry back to what it was. Back when, you know, the last great E3, in my opinion, was like, what, E3 2016? Or was it 2015, where they announced all these games that you see now that be getting sequels to? Let's take it back to that time. Microsoft, step your game up. Period. Step your freaking game up, bro. At this point, I've been with Sony. When I made the switch to go to PlayStation, I never regretted it. Still don't, as you can see. As you freaking can see. But anyway, that's beside the point. Microsoft, step your game up, bro. Period. That freaking monstrosity that you call Halo? Oh. Well, what's the name of the game? I don't know. It's forgettable. Period. It's forgettable. But the latest installment of Halo you're trying to push out? Pitiful. Pitiful. The gameplay you show, pitiful. The game looks dated. And what messes me up is that y'all preach to your fans or your fanboys, your slaves, that you have the strongest console. That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. That's cool. You can hold that little title of your heads or whatever. But at the end of the day, where are the games? Y'all remember the E3 when it was talking about the Inquisition of purchasing new studios, adding new studios to the garage and stuff. I remember the E3 quite vividly because the whole little segment was just dedicated to them talking about them acquiring new studios. But at the end of the day, where is the work? We've seen you're investing in your company. That's cool. But where is the work to show for it? Microsoft has Ninja Theory Studios, right? Do they not? They have Playground Studios. They have these great companies with great talent, but no work to show. You have all this muscle, but no work to show. You can't lift a pencil compared to this right now. So, Sony, I appreciate you. Hopefully, this will light a fire underneath the butts of these other companies. These rival companies out here, because we need competition. Competition breeds great work, great shit. Okay? Again, excuse my language. But I'm being honest, but I get passionate because I really care about gaming. I really do. And we've been dry for so freaking long, bro. And quite honestly, I've got tired of it. It got to a point where now I'm not even looking forward to the next E3 no more. Especially after last show, after that monstrosity. Politics, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Stuff that doesn't even matter to gaming itself. I felt like they just added that stuff in just for fillers, just to, so the time could be filled. To fill time spots. So moving forward, man. I know this video might fall on deaf ears, but as a gamer, a person that loves, a game enthusiast, should I say, please, take your time. Show work. It's good that you're acquiring studios. That's fine and dandy. That's not the problem here. The problem with me is that y'all have all this great talent, but nothing to show for it, man. So from now on, moving forward, we need to push gaming to the next level, man. We need to continue. We need to bring gaming back to what it was. You know what I'm saying? Something to be upholded and for great experiences and great memories. Let's bring it back, man. Let's continue.
War is coming. My story doesn't end hiding in these woods. I should be out there.
Hello, who is that?
Who Loki is?
It's you, fool. It's you. You are Loki.
The prophecies say Fimbulwinter leads right? to Ragnarok. War is coming.
Okay, so this is...
My story doesn't end hiding in these woods.
Okay, so
it's just there. Okay. Finding out who I am, who Loki is.
I will not allow you to pick a fight with God.
Is that his mom?
I don't want to.
Oh, that's the lady from.
I just want answers.
And if those answers lead to war with us,
from back in the first game.
Maybe that's what Mother wanted.
You do not know what Mother wanted.
Well, oh, the head, the freaking head. Yeah, he was pretty cool. The freaking head, I got the keychain, man. Look at that. And it talks, too. Hold up. Come on, you gonna do it? God dog, how you... Oh, crap. But it used to make noise. It used to talk. You know what I'm saying? And, Mimir! Yeah, just something, you know, I don't know why I showed you that, like, you pretty much care. but yeah, just something a part of the collector's edition.
I don't recognize that dour expression anywhere.
Odin's got tricks up his sleeve we haven't dared to consider.
What if there was Odin. Someone who could help us?
You mean Tyr?
Like who?
Of war in these lands. Who is dead?
Well, for a dead man, Odin seemed pretty keen on seeing he wasn't found.
Oh, wow.
If he's out there,
open world?
We gotta find him.
Come in.
Oh, the twin guy.
All yarns be the happen to him.
We're trying to stop Ragnarok, to help people. And what if the only way to do that is war?
Oh, man.
War is not the only way.
Stop look, thinking like look a at the coat, bro. Start thinking like a general.
You seem like a calm,
chain is chaos. Person.
Are you a calm and reasonable person?
Thor! Freaking Thor! Right? Is that Thor? Is that not? I mean, of course he has the hammer.
Crisis. Panic does nothing.
Oh man!
Let it serve you.
Tyr!
Are you coming with us?
Dang! But you know, God, you know, my boy Kratos, man, height don't mean nothing.
You'll get your answer soon enough.
Giant Slayer, Titan Slayer.
Well, some of them.
Aw, okay. What'd she say, though? What'd she say? I didn't hear what she said.
Let it serve you.
Ah! Get him, boy! Who is he?
With us.
Excuse me, man. My Tear. Random rock.
You'll get your answer soon enough. Well, some of them.
Okay, some of them. Got you. Hopefully the answers is worth it, which it will be. No telling, man, this game gonna come out, what, 2024, maybe? Probably even later. More updates in, what, 10 seconds? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now. Okay, so, more heat. Gameplay catcher on PS5 system. The program contains mature content, may not be suitable for audiences. All audiences. The views, expressions, and stress in the game.
Unbelievable! Yes, yes, inconceivable.
Oh, okay, so that's it. Reasonable, but at times I can be stubborn, so if I have okay, to move like the boat, I don't tend to take the easy. Put that on mute, because I don't know if is that copyrighted or not. But, yes, man. Then again, I might get copyright strike anyway, or copyright claim, because it was some music in here that was already used. And yeah, anyway, so moving forward, man, yeah, oh, Wolverine, oh my gosh, I can't wait to see how that's gonna play out, bro. You know what, I think, you know, from now on, honestly, this is might be jumping the gun a little bit, I might regret this, I don't know, but I feel like that game is gonna be awesome. I think Insomniac Games is the only studio that should have the license, full license to Marvel characters, the Marvel franchise, period. I think that should make that partnership happen. That would be big. That would be so freaking big. But I think, is it Marvel? Oh, hold on. We got dialogue here.
Showcase. We've got more info and updates coming right now. And I'm, in fact, joined by no less than PlayStation Studios head Herman Holst. Herman really strong showing here from PlayStation Studios tonight, including an awesome new look at GT7.
That's a hell of a
and
name.
And finally, a release date.
GT7 is coming in March, and I don't think fans are going to be disappointed with what Yamauchi-san and Polyphony have been working on. And what we're doing with GT7 is we're pulling from the entire history of the franchise, okay, taking so some of the best features
into GT7. Number 23.
GT campaign, arcade missions, all that good stuff.
The second time we've seen that number 23.
And, you know, I got a chance to play, and it just looks and plays sensationally. The haptics, the vibrations, you feel the rolls, the pull and the weight of the, okay, of the different cars. I'll tell you, the one thing that
turn
I
that down. Really, really liked. Because they're talking about racing and stuff. But yeah, I really feel like Marvel should make that partnership.
Great to hear that about you.
They made that happen, man.
I can't wait to play that, but I also really wanted to talk about Insomniac. I
mean, yeah, that is Insomniac
on fire the last year, maybe 18 months with Marvel Spider-Man Miles Morales, Ratchet and Clank, A Rift Apart, and now two big reveals tonight in the form of Marvel Spider-Man 2 and Marvel's Wolverine.
Yes.
It's kind of a shock. You work really closely with Insom, Herman. So what can you tell us about just why Insom gets so fired up about the Marvel Universe?
Elaborate.
I mean, Sid, you said it. Insomniac are on fire. They've been just so productive. And I think the team in Insomniac, they're really always challenging themselves to raise the bar with their approach to storytelling and craftsmanship. And it's really evident in the consistently high quality of games that they've been delivering over the years. I think on top of that, they really, really prize collaboration amongst their team. And that collaboration that also extends to the way that they work with other PlayStation teams, but also their work with their great partners at Marvel, and that collaboration resulted in the amazing first two Marvel Spider-Man games.
Yes.
And I know that Insomniac are extremely excited to be further expanding the universe into Marvel Spider-Man 2 now.
And you know what? He just said that I think it is a partnership. I'm sorry if I keep pausing the game, the showcase, but then again, y'all probably ought to watch this already. Either way, but this is my reaction, so if you don't like my reactions, you can just click out the video. But anyway, honestly, I feel like they should be the only ones that's capable of handling Marvel titles. I mean, of course, like I said, I'm speaking too early because they only have two games to show for, but those two games are just freaking good. You know what I'm saying? It's exactly what they shown when they first showcased it at whatever E3, they showcased it at. And it's the same product that we've seen then. It's the same product that after released. You know what I'm saying? And I think they've shown us they are fully capable of handling these big titles, man. And for the future of Insomniac Games, I can't wait to see what else they can do. You know what I'm saying? Because if Wolverine comes out and it's freaking crazy and it's freaking crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like you just said, man, Insomniac Games has been on fire, dog. I have yet to play the Ratchet and Clank, the new one, Rift Apart. But I even heard that game is freaking good. So, you know, hey, the sky's the limit for this company. Because they're doing big things, man. Like I said, they are the new Sucker Punch right now. Back when Sucker Punch announced Infamous and Infamous 2, Second Son was, but it's still a Sucker Punch game. And then on top of that, Ghost of Tsushima. So these two companies where it's like the two big heads or the two big dogs right now that, you know, that Sony has and many other studios as well, like Naughty Dog Studios. But we have yet to see like another Uncharted game. Unfortunately, I feel like we're not going to see another Uncharted game for years to come or whatever. But Naughty Dog Studios, I think Naughty Dog need to, you know, make a new IP, maybe. I don't know, because my chart is pretty much done. My boy Drake, Nathan Drake, is pretty much getting old. You know what I'm saying? As seen in the fourth installment of the series. So, I don't know. But like I said, Sony, man, in some of their games, yes, I think they should, you know, be the only company. And like I said, the sky is not the limit for this this group, these talented workers, man, these developers. I would love to see a Blade game moving forward. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Or a Spawn game. That would be freaking awesome. Or a Deadpool game. Like I said, my brain is going. My imagination is getting cranked up. I would love to see these games come to full fruition, man. Like, you know, just all these ideas, all the things they can do with Marvel. All the characters, man. It's a vast library of characters they can do standalone games on. You know what I'm saying? And it's like the work is not there. They just got to put it into full fruition. But moving forward, Spider-Man 2 does look awesome. Venom is in there. And then Wolverine, man, look here. Let's just continue, man.
And they're also going to be raising the bar again, you know, in terms of immersion, action, visual fidelity. I think Marvel Spider-Man 2 will be a spectacular showpiece for gaming. And they're also so thrilled to then bring gamers an emotional and a suspenseful journey.
Can we get Jack Human to revise his role?
PlayStation fans are really going to be in for a treat over the next few years.
Very cool, very exciting times, and on multiple fronts. Tonight, we also got our first big look at God of War Ragnarok. Herman, what can you tell us about where Santa Monica Studio is going with this one?
You know, like many of the fans, I'm personally really, really invested in the relationship between Kratos and Atreus. We got to see in the trailer that there's some real tension brewing between them as Ragnarok approaches. So, you know, I can't wait for players to see how that relationship between them evolves. And you gotta trust me when I say that Santa Monica Studio have prepared quite a few twists and turns for players
as they
set up the finale of the Norse saga in God of War Ragnarok.
And you know the boss fight is about to be crazy in the Ragnarok, God of War Ragnarok, bro. Because you know, it's one thing about Santa Monica Studios, but they love to one-up themselves with each installment of God of War. That was shown back in the original God of War days, the OG God of War days. You know what I'm talking about. Like, they always had to one-up themselves with each installment. And put out fire content with each installment. Even the spinoffs, or not even the spinoff, or, you know, the games that, you know, it was in the God of War universe, well, the OG God of War universe, but still, it was pretty freaking good. Like, when the PSP days, I remember God of War, Chains of Olympus. I'm stuttering. I'm sighting. Let me calm down. Let me pipe down. Okay? With God of War, Chains of Olympus, that game was freaking awesome, even on PSP. Like I said, man, Santa Monica Studios, but they have the sauce. They have the sauce, man. They got the secret ingredient. Moving forward with Ragnarok, I can't wait to see what they have for that. So
we're going to get an update on God of War Ragnarok from Santa Monica Studio here in just a moment. But before you go, Herman, I wanted to get your take on Horizon Forbidden West. Now, we've learned that this one is coming out in February. I am sure that by this point you have played it. So what has jumped out to you? What can you tell us about the game?
I've had a chance to play the game on PS4 and PS5, and it looks great on both. For PS5, the level of detail on Aloy, her kids, their lighting, it's just exceptional. Even more amazing because the environments have so much going on too. From the ruins of San Francisco to those new underwater areas, everything looks breathtaking. Yeah. And it loads really fast because of the SSD. Plus, the combat in the game offers so much variety. It's all based on player choice. There's so many cool weapons and tools.
God,
when you combine these together,
it's a good looking game,
really handy when you're dealing with the new machines. On PS5, the haptic feedback on the controller, I think in my mind, really adds to the experience, you know, when you're firing arrows and the other ammo. You know, the team at Guerrilla, I know them so well. I'm super proud of them. They're creating something incredibly special. And I just can't wait for gamers to get the next chapter of Aloy's adventure in their hands.
Thanks for the update, Herman. We're joined now by Eric and Corey from Santa Monica Studio. And I wanted to check in with you two on the big announcement.
Corey Ballard, let's go, baby.
God of War Ragnarok. We finally got our big look at it. And actually, Eric, I wanted to start with you.
He even has the tat right here, too.
You've been involved with every single God of War, including 2018's God of War. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct, Sid. I've been with the studio since 2004. In many different capacities, working with both Santa Monica and Randy at Dawn on the God of War franchise.
Eric Williams.
I don't know why, but they thought it'd be a good idea to say, hey, do you want to direct this one? And so that's what I'm doing. I'm directing God of War Ragnarok, or as Corey likes to call it, never heard of it. So that's the update on that.
So, Eric, why the shift in leadership on God of War
Corey
Ragnarok?
Ballard,
it's always been a tradition here at Santa Monica to change the directors across the games. You know, we've had really good success with that. Corey's been the only repeat director, and, you know, rightfully so. He's pretty damn good at what he does.
Yes.
So that's kind of what it is.
Yes.
The important thing for us is to be able to kind of get a fresh perspective each time, but also, you know, a fresh pair of legs in the sense that you're really exhausted at the end of finishing one of these things.
I imagine so.
Somebody else into doing it, like him.
So, Eric, what aesthetics or themes sort of resonate with you as a creative? I mean, I guess what I'm getting at is, like, how do you see yourself leaving your fingerprints on God of War Ragnarok?
It's kind of the designer in me wants to answer one way, but as a director, you have to answer a different way. I think you have to learn how to jettison your own a profession when you switch over to the director's role, which I'm sure Corey can understand. I mean, he kind of animated a little bit on God of War 2, and we kind of had to throw it all out, except for that sneaky backflip that Kratos has never done again that we left in. That's the perk of being the director, I guess. But, you know, from my point of view, like, we want to tell a very heartfelt and epic story as father and son.
Right.
Go on a journey, and they kind of struggle with holding on to stuff and letting go of things.
Something really grounded.
It's a difficult kind of human condition that we all deal with.
Right.
And we kind of want to arrive at that by taking, like, slices of life. Or,
and you know what? I'm going to pause right here. I'm sorry again if I keep pausing the video. But again, bro, even in the first God of War, that was a big step up from what we were used to or what we was accustomed to from Kratos. Kratos never had to really had to deal with the struggle or the new challenge of being a father, you know, so, or being a parent. You know, he's just always been gung-ho, kill this, kill that, you know. Like a dude is used to slaying Titans, Titan Slayer. Really, Attack on Titan, need to get with Kratos, bro. He know the songs. But anyway, side of point, little anime reference there. But anyway, yeah, Kratos, you know what I'm saying? He's all his life, all he knows is war. Hence the name God of War. You know what I'm saying? He's nothing but smoke. He's free smoke for everybody. He's a smokertarian. That's a word. So I smoke Tyrion. You know what I'm saying? He lives and breathes smoke. You know what I'm saying? He's fighting. He knows nothing but throw hands and kill things. So him, us seeing a new side of him, or him getting older, you know, him having more wisdom, as he does, and trying to teach Atreus that as well, it's a new challenge for him. You know what I'm saying? That's a boss battle in itself, being a parent. So, seeing this out of Kratos, man, and moving forward with the franchise, I think, you know, they do, like, as we just heard, they want to build upon that and tell the story of, you know, just that, him doing that, and add new things into the to the game as well. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, one thing about Santa Monica Studios, I'm going to keep repeating this too, because it's so true. With each installment, they try to one-up themselves, and I love that. You know what I'm saying? You love to see something great become greater, evolve. You know what I'm saying? And that's what Kratos is doing. And I think that's what they're trying to go with this one, with this game installment. So hopefully we'll see what they have in mind or in store with that narrative. So let's keep on.
Family, you know, drama, if you will, and kind of juxtapose that against big Norse backdrop. And, you know, at the end, we just want to have an ending that feels very, you know, surprising yet inevitable based on all those things. But it's kind of, you know, I'm from the Midwest, so like slice of life, very common, mundane things are just as interesting as big world events. And so we try to collide those things together. It's, you know, make an experience that's very worthy of the God of War name.
So with the game officially being called God of War Ragnarok, I guess
it... You remember, again, pause it. If you remember, you seen Atreus hold the deer over his head, lets you know that he learned a lot from the previous God of War game. Because if you remember, Kratos was trying to teach him how to hunt. You know what I'm saying? He was learning, teaching the boy how to fend for himself if he wasn't there. And now you've seen this dude pretty much carrying the game over his head, bringing food back to the camp. That showed you his growth. He's getting older. He learned a whole lot from God of War, from the previous game. And like I said, man, I can't wait to see what they do with Atreus in the previous and continue with the installments, man. You know what I'm saying? I can't wait to see how that plays out. So
it doesn't take a genius to think that perhaps Ragnarok factors into this game in some manner. Can you confirm that, Eric?
Yeah, I mean, you can't call the game God of War Ragnarok and not have Ragnarok happen in the game. So, you know, it's going to happen. We're going to cap off the Norse series with it. And I think Chris Judge said it best.
Hold up. Run that back. What he said? What did he say?
And not have Ragnarok happen in the game. So, you know, it's going to happen. We're going to cap off the Norse series.
You heard that, right? We're going to cap off the Norse series. So what is the next one? Because from what we understand, okay, so Kratos been through the Greek mythology within the new installment, God of War. He pretty much is about to finish the Norse mythology. So what is the next one? Christianity? I don't know. That would be crazy, wouldn't it? Seeing Kratos go against, like, Jesus Christ, God, the all who created the world. You know what I'm saying? That would be crazy. Kratos versus Jesus. Jesus is like, you're going to run his hands, Kratos. That would be funny. But anyway, let's keep it
with it. And I think Chris Judge said it best in the announce trailer last year. Prepare yourselves.
The last game ended with a teaser of sorts for Thor.
Right.
And I just got to know, was that Thor's voice we heard in the trailer just a few minutes ago?
Yes.
That was definitely Thor's voice.
Of course.
That we heard in the trailer. Thor is being played by Ryan Hurst. But you might know him from Sons of Anarchy. He played Opie, one of my favorite characters ever.
Okay. I've never seen this show.
Delighted to have him come play in the God of War sandbox. And his take on Thor and our take visually on Thor is very different than the hunky Australian you might know.
You know what? I would love to hear Thor been voiced by the guy that played Hellboy. You know, I forgot his name. I'm going to post this picture on the screen somewhere. But I think his voice would be perfect for like a Thor, that, you know, that deep, gritty voice. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't know. It's just a thought, man.
You know, he's much closer to the Norse mythology version. You know, he's this big, burly, almost hedonistic man-child, red hair, you know, left-handed, just a little off kilter than the Thor that a lot of people know right now. So I can't wait for people to experience more of that when the game's done.
We also heard the name Odin in tonight's trailer. So I imagine if we're going to experience Ragnarok, Odin's going to have to play a pretty big role here, right?
Definitely. I mean, Odin is the Allfather of all the realms, so he's going to show up when Ragnarok happens. We're very, very happy to have Mr. Richard Schiff come on to play Odin for us. You may know him as Toby from The West Wing. This was one that we never thought was going to happen. It was like kind of a shot in the dark, and he got back to us, and we walked him around the mocap volume, and he was just like, I've never done anything like this before. Let's do it. And so the kind of rest is history. So I can't wait for people to experience that and see how he factors in. And it's a very different take, again, much like Thor. You know, he's like a old man who's just kind of busy with his own things and doing whatever he wants. And he doesn't live in a castle or anything like that. So it's a different take, kind of what we do. We just take what's known and curveball it a little bit and, you know, make it special.
We also saw a couple of new characters tonight. So what can you tell us about them?
Are you talking about the little squid? Oh no, you're talking about Tyr, the big guy. Yeah, he's the Norse god of war. And Kratos and Atreus have finally found him. We talked a lot about him in 2018, so we were like, well, we might as well show him to the people. And then the last character we saw at the trailer, you know, like with the little wink and smile from Angerboda, she's one of the last remaining giants, and her story is pretty amazing and how it fits into the world of God of War. Tyr is being played by Ben Prendergast, who's been completely absorbed in the role, even though he is not a giant as Tyr is. And then Angerboda is being played by Leia De Leon Hayes, who's a complete treasure on set. She's been amazing. Watching her chemistry with the other characters has been amazing. And she's one of the last giants that's living. So we have those characters and a few more. You know, there's a lot of different monsters you saw in there. And it's been so many talented people at the studio building this trailer and putting it together. I just want to give a shout out to the team. I love you guys. You know, I wish you could be here doing this interview with me. I wish you were all behind me right now at the studio. That would have been completely amazing. And, you know, lastly, to our fans, we have a saying at the studio that we are fans of our fans, and I cannot wait to watch all the tweets, the messages, the reaction videos that you guys put out, and our team to be able to take that into heart.
You know what? Again, pausing the video. Moving forward, bro, Santa Monica Studios, I think they are really good at, they are really freaking good at what they do. You know what I'm saying? Which is the God of War series. And it's cool. That's just amazing. You know what I'm saying? I love their work. Been a fan of the franchise since the beginning. You know what I'm saying? Still have the games to this day. I still play them, bro. Like, great titles, man. Such a great legacy they have left on the gaming industry as a whole, and what they brought to us. But moving forward, dude, I think, like I said, I don't really see them going off of it. I think, you know, I would love to see them take on a new challenge, a new game, a new IP. You know what I'm saying? Because Santa Monica, they have the talent. They have the talent there. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to see what else could, you know, what else could they do? You know, like I said, God of War, Kratos is getting older. You know, no telling how long he's going to be able to hold out. Because, you know, in the first iteration of God of War, before this one, he was getting old. And it was shown. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't have that little, that spunk he used to have. He still has it, though. He's far from resting. He still has it. Trust and believe. But he's getting older. And it's showing. So I think moving forward, either they're going to, you know, take on the story of Atreus getting older and coming Loki as well, because we all know it. I think the game was alluding to him being Loki. So, yeah, they might just take that story and just focus on Atreus as he's getting older and stuff, becoming his own god. You know, I'm saying, he's a god as well. But yeah, I would love to see them, like, you know, take on a new challenge, a new IP, man. You know, I would love to see what they can do. Bring a new hero that we can go to adore, such as Kratos, you know what I'm saying? And then again, how can you one up Kratos, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like they could if they really wanted to. So coming from a studio like them, I would love to see them take on a new IP. So, yeah.
Part and just get excited and hyped and then use that to push us through to finish the game for you guys. So thank you very much.
Now, Corey, we haven't heard a whole lot out of you here tonight. So now that we know you're not directing God of War Ragnarok, I was hoping maybe you could give us a little clue about what you may or may not be working on next.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? You'd like me to just spill the beans and tell you everything that's going on right now. We're actually doing a bunch of stuff. It's really exciting.
Sorry, Corey. Hold on. I apologize if the video quality if my web cam over, if it got dark, cause of course it got darker because it's like, what, 6 o'clock now, about to hit 7. So, you know, I'm sorry, you know, if it was dark for a quick second, but I hope the light is enough. Let me see. Let me check it out real quick. See if the light is doing anything. I'm in the shot. Let me see. Okay, so it wasn't that dark. I'm tripping. Okay, so, yeah. So, let's continue.
All the things that we're doing, and you're tempted to know what is this, but I don't really have anything I can talk about right now, specifically, mostly because we're really focused on God of War Ragnarok, that I am incredibly excited that I finally understand that that's what everyone was saying, God of War Ragnarok. I was way off. I was thinking it was something else that they were talking about. I think we'll wait to get any deeper into anything else until later. We'll talk again, Sid.
All right. Well, thank you, Corey, and thank you, Eric. And next up, we have Ryan Treadwell. He's the lead producer at Aspyr. And wouldn't you know, just a little while ago, we got the announcement of a remake for Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. So, Ryan, I guess...
Another title that's been... I never got a chance to play the original when it, I think it came on PS2 and PC, I think, back in the day. Never got a chance to, you know, that's another thing. Star Wars, as a franchise, I never really got into until, like, later. Like, the only games that come to mind with me is, like, Star Wars Force Unleashed and Force Unleashed 2. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not really a big fan of Star Wars. I'm not, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and admit that. But I always been intrigued, though. And I always wanted to get into the franchise, but I didn't know where to start. You know what I'm saying? And, yeah, I always wanted to get into this franchise, man. And, because it seemed like the fans of the franchise, like, legit fans. And of course, they're a lot older than us, you know what I'm saying? And, or than me, personally. You know what I'm saying? Because I think this franchise started back in, what, 1980-something? Or maybe, like, 1970. Somewhere between that time in 1970 and 1980s. But, so, yeah, a lot of the fans of this franchise are a bit older. You know, which is beside the point, but this game, though, I heard a lot of great things about it. It's highly talked about in the gaming, in the gaming sphere, should I say, as one of the, like, a good, solid Star Wars game. But I'm glad they're making a remake, because a lot of people like me that hadn't gotten a chance to play the original can play this remake. And hopefully it'll be, new friendly and can possibly introduce me to this franchise that I've been wanting to be a part of for a very long time. So, yeah, this, I'm kind of curious about this.
I guess my question is this like a remaster of the original game, or what's going on here?
It's so much more, Sid. This is a complete remake of this beloved Star Wars story. Yeah. For Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic remake, we are rebuilding from the ground up while maintaining that integrity of story and character from the original.
So Ryan, how much of a remake are we talking about here? I mean, is this updating some graphics,
from the ground up,
some higher resolution modes?
You know, the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic is a true classic and one of our favorite Star Wars stories ever. We want to honor that original story and make it as impactful for players today. In terms of the visuals, we have an opportunity to present this story with a much higher level of fidelity than was possible in the past, while making sure that we're being authentic to what players loved about that original game.
So we know Aspyr from bringing classic Star Wars games to modern consoles, but this is a much bigger project than anything the studio's tackled before. So what can you tell me about the team behind the game?
You're absolutely right. While Aspyr has enjoyed a great relationship with Lucasfilm Games through our work bringing classic Star Wars games to new audiences on modern platforms, this project is on a completely different level to anything we have done before. That's why we knew we had to assemble the right team to do this project justice. We put together a team full of industry veterans from fan-favorite RPGs, even including the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It has been a really rewarding experience to assemble such a talented team to bring back an epic game. Of course, we're also working closely with the amazing teams at PlayStation and Lucasfilm Games. Together, we couldn't be more excited about what we'll be able to show you in the future.
I'm excited, man.
Of course, huge Star Wars fans too. One of the nice parts about building a team to make a big Star Wars game is the ability to instantly bond with all the new people over your favorite aspects of Star Wars. We all have different Star Wars memorabilia behind us in every call, and it always sparks up a good conversation.
All right, thanks, Ryan. Very exciting stuff, and I'm definitely dying to see more of that one.
Thank you, Sid. It will be some time before we're ready to show more, but we're very excited about being able to reveal more in the future.
All right, and that's it for our show. You can catch up on all the big news on PlayStation.blog and check out all the trailers from tonight's PlayStation Showcase on YouTube. Thanks for watching.
See you later, man. Okay. Yeah, what a showcase, man. As to be expected, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, coming into this thing, I ain't gonna lie to you. I had really low expectations. That seems to be it. But yeah, I had really low expectations coming to this thing because, you know, like I said, coming off of E3, the last showing they had, Monstrosity again, I was not really hyped about the showcase. But then again, it was a slimmer of hope that I had for Sony because, you know, they tend to not let us down. And when they show some stuff, they show good stuff, like worth watching. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, mine is the, you know, the racing game or Gran Turismo. You know, mine is that. But it seemed like they made it a focal point throughout the whole showcase that they're going to show new stuff. And that's exactly what they did here. Versus something like Microsoft conference or whatever. It's basically 90% freaking what? Forza. You know what I'm saying? That's the whole showcase. It's not Forza. And like indie games and stuff like that, which is to each his own, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, like I said, they have all those studios, all that great talent behind underneath their belt, but no work to show for it. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, like I said, moving forward, man, I hope the gaming industry as a whole, I hope this showcase will be like a beacon. Or an example of what gamers would like to see. And I think they satisfied. I'm walking away with this the showcase feeling completely satisfied, man. I'm hyped for the future of Sony. You know what I'm saying? And I'm excited to see what they have in store for us, man. Like I said, Spider-Man 2, Venom. Possibly can we get like a Venom standalone game out of that? Or DLC. Who knows, man? Or maybe we can play as Venom in the game. You never know. Because, you know, he might take over, like I said, Peter Parker, or he might take over Miles Morales at some parts of the game and whatever, man. That, like I said, it's my imagination is going wild. And then on top of that, we have Wolverine to look forward to with Insomniac Games, man. Insomniac Games, bro. Legit, I think as the gaming community, we actually deem you the best developer for Marvel titles, period, bro. I don't really trust any other developer team besides you. Like I said, Insomniac Games is slowly becoming the new Sucker Punch, bro. Slowly but surely, man. And not saying Sucker Punch is like losing its flair because, of course, I have still yet to beat Ghost of Tsushima, but Ghost of Tsushima is freaking phenomenal. They're still releasing DLCs for that. I think they just not released on online mode or whatever. I forgot what it's called. It's called Legends or something. Something like that. I heard it's pretty freaking cool. And it's like PvE or something like that. So they're still adding on to the game even maybe, what is it, like 2 or 3 years? I want to say 2 years or a year or so after its release. So they're still, like I said, they're still adding value to the game even after its release. So kudos to them. But Insomniac Games, man, yes, they are on fire, bro. So moving forward, man, like I said, the showcase was on. If I had to grade it, I would give it a solid A. Not an A plus, but an A, a good solid A. Like I said, I'm walking away from this thing feeling satisfied. I'm feeling hyped for the future of Sony. And yeah, so I'm not gonna drag this video out any longer. You know what I'm saying? Cause I know this video is gonna be, it's an hour and 33 minutes. So I gotta get the editing. So I will see you guys next time. And as always, if you like the video, please leave a like on the video. And like I said, this is just my reaction. I know I came late after like a good hour and some minutes after the showcase actually aired because I wanted to capture this live, you know what I'm saying, as it was showing. But then again, it is also perks to come in late because you get to see, you get to cut to the actual showcase instead of watching, you know, the blue screen or whatever. Or what have you not. But yeah, man, I'll see you guys next time, man. And man, as always, that's it. And I'm out.